In this Fixture Friday, we're gonna talk about this pallet that frees you up for 30 minutes while it makes 18 parts. Okay, the part we're making today is the forked portion that goes on the bottom of our vacuum power unit. The old way was to hold 4 parts in a double vise, 2 for op 1, and then flip them for op 2 in the other set of jaws. By making this pallet, we're making 18 at a time for op 1, and then run op 2 in the double vise 4 at a time in another machine. Now by shifting production to this one-piece flow between two machines, we now get 36 finished parts in the first hour. Now, you might ask, why not do both operations on one pallet like last week's Fixture Friday? Well, we believe in continual improvement, and creating a set of pallets for op 1 is just the first step. We might do that in the future, to be honest. But the bigger point is that I always encourage customers to not overwhelm themselves with trying to create the perfect multi-operation pallet. Start small, keep it simple, and you'll still see amazing throughput by palletizing the first operation alone. Okay, let's talk about the design. This is an 8-inch by 16-inch pallet. We minimized our need to saw individual parts and get 6 pieces per blank. Now the interesting thing we do here is that we slot apart every other part so that 2 parts come connected at the end of the cycle. Now we can take this set of 2 parts and put it in the vise with 1 work stop, and they're both perfectly spaced for the second operation. This was one of the easiest pallets to design because I started with just 1 part and duplicated it in a grid pattern to get 3 rows of 6. Now I also want to highlight 2 things, these arrows and this corner. The arrows are simply a reminder to the operator to slide the workpiece to the end of the pallet. Now this corner is a touch-off point that we use as an optional pallet origin. We machine sides for X and Y, and the top of it for Z. Now, this gives the operator a machined edge to touch off of instead of a less accurate sawn edge of a part. Now, I'll cover the best practices for origins in the next Fixture Friday, but this corner is a nice thing to have to quickly probe to verify setups. Like usual, we've created pockets for the clamps, not slots, and we've also installed helicoil thread inserts for longer thread life. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to our channel. These Fixture Friday videos are just a small part of the things we share about business and manufacturing. So until next time, go innovate your production.